Subscribe to the channel and click on bell icon for continued updates.
So when I say PY 1819, when I say PY 1819, what does it mean? AY 1920. What does this mean? What is this time period? Kab se kab tak? From when to where? This will be assumption. This will be the assumption. When I say PY 1819, it means from 1st April 18 to 31st March 19. So when your previous year is not a complete year, okay, your previous year is not a complete year, how can you write only PY 1819? If your previous year is beginning from a date within a year, it can be 30th September, 30th August, 1st December, 15th February, anything. I hope you know, it can begin within a year. In which situations? When a new business or profession is set up or the income is earned for the first time. Yes or no? Section 3. Explanation to section 3. How can you write PY 1819 only? So some of you are asking me, right? Questions were asked about previous year and assessment year. And you have very nicely, very easily for all the questions, sub questions, very conveniently written PY 1819. Right? And you thought that is kind of very simple question. Right? So those who actually paid attention, I had actually mentioned when we were studying PY-AY that we want the dates. Even when you say it is from PY-1418 to 31319, it is always better to write down those dates. So specifically when those questions are about section 3, date of setup, and the previous year is commencing from not from 1st April, it is very obvious that you have to write from that date up to 31st March 19 as the previous year. Because when you write PY-1819, the assumption is obviously it begins from 1st April. Which in that case might be a wrong answer. Understood? I also said whether assessment year will be a half year.
No.
Assessment is always obviously a full year. In that case, it was fine to write assessment year 1920 only. But previous year can be a period of less than 365 days or less than 1 year. Understood this? And in the last cases of that exceptional cases, okay, person leaving India. Previous year and assessment year are separate or same?
Same.
They are same. Okay. So, for example, now if a person is leaving on 30th September 2018, the previous year will begin from this period or it will end at this period? It will end at this period, obviously. So, the previous year in this case would have been 1418 to 31st March 18. Sorry, 30th September 18. This will be your previous year, and assessment year is also 1819. Understood this? Yes. Okay. So those who have taken the shortcut, written only PY 1819. Obviously, your answer is incorrect. Okay. That depends now on my mercy. How many times do I have to tell you? I don't understand this. I understand this. Okay, I have not started yet checking. So, those who have not done, make that habit of practice right now. You are not doing a favor on me by writing answers. I had given you ample time to write the answer. So, obviously, I expected columns at least. Okay, those have only written answers very nicely. All the numbers on right hand side. Where are the lines? Where are the formats? Okay. If at all there is a difference between inner column and outer column, you have to write, at least show the lines. Yes. Are you following this? Then, over here, common mistakes. I was talking of common mistakes. And one of the most important mistakes only few of you have done, not all of you, few of you. One is a very common sense is start with that question with which you are comfortable, most comfortable. In question paper, they may say the question number one is compulsory. But when did I say you have to attempt question number one first? You can attempt it in any sequence. Okay, whenever you attempt a question, even the sub question should be attempted at that time. don't again jump from sub-question to sub-question. I hope you understand question and sub-question. So whenever you start a question, finish that entire question. But you can start with any question, no? It can be question number 3 or 5 or 8, doesn't matter. As an advisor, I'll always tell you, whenever you get a question paper, always reverse it. Usko ulta karo. You will get an entire booklet, bunch of 8-10 pages at least, okay, for per paper. So always reverse it. Usually the last questions are the easiest ones. Are you following this? Usually the last questions are the easiest one. So I will always suggest that never ever read first question in any paper. In our test, whatever is happening in classes, that is okay. First question might be easy, but you know, usually have a practice of reading the simple questions. So first of all, go through all the questions, then decide the easiest one and then start with that. Because when I open from my point of view, now from an examiner's point of view, when I open a sheet to check, if I'm going to see lots of cancellations, overwriting, mistakes, etc. on the first page, that is definitely going to impact my impression. What do you say? First impression is the last impression. So on the first page itself, if I'm going to see lots of mistakes, cutting, underwriting, overwriting, jo bhi hai, all of that, obviously that is going to impact my marks on the next of the questions, even if you might have written it very nicely. So first question always the easiest question, or at least easiest or toughest, whatever it might be, presentation has to be very good. Yes? Following? Yes or no? Then, from question number 1 itself, question number 1 was of 50 lakhs 90,000 rupees 4. Okay? That was the taxable income. I think no deductions was given, no chapter 6 deduction available, correct? And non-resident? Yes, so most of you have taken basic exemption limit of 2,50,000, which is right. But many of you, not many of you again, but some of you have not rounded off that income at 50,90,000. Some of you very smart students have rounded off the tax liability while calculating the third slab of above 10 lakh rupees. Of above 10 lakh rupees. Up to first 10 lakh rupees, it is rounded off 1,12,500. Yes or no? And then next what happens? Above 10 lakhs means 40,90,000. Yes? Into 30%. So some of you have not rounded up initially, you rounded up the tax liability here. 40,90,004 into 30%. Now rounded off under section 288A. What do you round off under 288A? Net taxable income, not tax liability. Some very smart students. When you are calculating tax liability, very basic common sense. If it is a positive amount, means what? Payable. Yes. If it is a negative amount, means what? Tax liability. Negative. There is a difference between nil and negative. Receivable, but obviously, refund. Yes or no? So, many of you got positive calculation, this positive number, tax liability, final tax liability. So obviously it is kind of payable. Okay, so if at all by chance you get a negative number over here, it means what? Refund. That means you have paid tax in excess than your actual tax liability. This is the common sense. Understood or no? I also told you, whenever you have profit, positive income, only in that case you might get positive tax liability. That means payable. So obviously when you have loss, don't calculate tax on loss. Loss means negative number. Again on that, you'll calculate tax 30%. Again 30% negative number, and then you'll ask for refund. So keep one very simple thing in mind. Tax liability positive means payable. Nil means not payable. Pay attention. Nil means not payable. It also means whatever was the tax liability, you have already paid it. What am I saying? Tax liability nil means what? Whatever was payable, you have paid it. So you don't further have to pay it now. And what do you mean by tax liability negative? Excess paid. Excess paid than required. That is a situation of refund. Rebate is of rupees. You get rebate of up to rupees 2,500, 2,000, up to. Yes or no? Very good. Tax liability 1,500. And rebate taken off 2,500. Income tax department will keep on finding you. Tell me, who is this consultant? who is taking rebate benefit and claiming refund. Okay? So obviously 1500 minus 2500, negative. It means what? Income tax department will come searching for you. Which kind of consultant is this? Following? You can take maximum benefit of 2500. It means what? In this case, you will take up to 1500. In that situation, tax liability should be nil. Remember this? Fine. And apart from that, some of you have to work on your presentation. Okay? Presentation means, as far as possible, no overwriting, cancellation, everything. If you think that you have done lots of overwriting, leave that question. Cross mark matlab, entirely. That is the only, if at all you have time again. Okay, and then reattempt it properly, nicely. Okay, then, like I said, your handwriting should be, what did I say? Legible. Matlab what? Readable. Okay, so don't do anything like this. I have to understand, this is a tax now. Rupees, something like this. You're not drawing symbols or art. That is not art paper, okay? So be a little specific. Chalega aisa. Okay? It has to be understood, no? So whatever is your handwriting, especially cursive wale, keep some space or it should be understood. And those who have small font, small size of handwriting, try to now increase the font or size of your, whatever is your writing. Okay, it should be now readable very easily. Okay? And working notes, they are known as working notes because they are not part of your main answer. Working notes come after your main answer. Yes? We give reference of working notes in your main answer. Are you following this? So in that question itself, whatever you are actually finding answer, and there you again going to write working notes. In the main answer itself, you are going to write down all the calculation and then continue with your answer. How are we going to understand where your main answer gets over and where is your working notes? Don't mix the working notes with the main answer. Keep it separate. Are you following this? So whenever you calculate marginal relief, you should have just kept one line over there. Less marginal relief, working note number one. And then you should have arrived at the main answer, and then after the main answer, you have to actually calculate the marginal relief. Understood clear? Yes? Fine. This is just my observation I have gone through only, upar se. Just a brief checking, okay? And one important thing obviously I will tell you before you start blaming me. From my side, the delivery is same to all of you. What I am teaching to all of you is obviously uniform. I am not taking separate special classes after 5:30 or on Sundays. Okay, so from my side it is same. But for the same first question number one of 50,90,000 rupees four. Okay, if the tax liabilities are different for different students, obviously it is not my mistake. Okay, so many of you I think have got the right answer along with marginal relief. So those of you have to now pay attention. Those of you have not got that, at least question number one right, you need to practice a lot. Okay, I have not given yet marks, so on marks obviously you will understand better. But still, if the first question itself you could not arrive it properly, you need to start working seriously. So this should give you a kind of opportunity to understand where you are lacking. How much was the answer? 14,58,600 of question one, I think. Okay, I remember only that amount.